So it's been almost 10 days since we are, since I'm in Barcelona, and I think it's like the longest I've been living in a hotel. Honestly, I like it. I kind of understand now why Coco Chanel was living in a hotel all the time. So the reason I'm here was actually, to be honest, no specific reason. Mostly because I was just, I got super tired at work, and the whole summer was so overwhelming, and this opportunity came up. Here I am. At first we thought it's gonna be just a week, but we ended up spending here 10 days, and I think we will stay for like 4 days more, which means that, you know, at some point I decided, well, there is a YouTube I used to have, should I start again? Because I really have some time, like some free time. In the morning I'm busy with the thing that happened back home with work, but most of the time afternoons I spend like walking, visiting places, museums, all those kind of things. And so starting over with this whole YouTube thing, and want to show you a little bit of my life here in Barcelona, which is absolutely something completely new for me. There is like a life, my life in Paris and my life in Normandy, and this is completely new. Well, what I am striving to do here is like to keep up with my routine the same as I would do in Almaty or in Paris, you know, like incorporating, keeping up, doing the same stuff, like meditate, waking up early, work, workout, making enough steps every day. So far, I've been doing it pretty well, except the meditations are hard. I don't know, when I switch places, I feel that I'm too used to the space and I'm getting comfortable. So this has been a bit of a struggle, but the rest, like physical activity and the food as well. Okay, first days I've been like thinking, what should I eat? There is like a lot of, all of the foods here are quite greasy, and I don't know, they fry all those stuff. But you know, finally I found my way, and I found few places that I like, a chain of restaurants in the city that I can eat at. Name one of those are Honest Greens, really amazing, like a huge portion of salads, exactly what I needed. So basically I'm pretty good with that. Let's go live our life. A place called Moltama, and it's really, really nice. You can expect that. You don't have like the one.
Oh, that normal.
Normal is like
cheese, orange cheese.
Okay. No, none of us. Funniest part about all of this, like orders, you order in English and then you add cafes. So here's the breakfast. I'm not going to eat this part, just the eggs, the salmon and the cheese. So there's enough of fats and protein for me to get through the day and get until the lunch. Again, coffee, one more coffee.
Honestly, one of the best salmons like pure salmons I had so far. I mean, in Barcelona. Because others are like just too much salt.
We were looking for a place to have breakfast at, and my husband sees this place, says healthy and gluten-free, and he freaks out. Like, no, we're not going here. It's like they are about to feed him, I don't know, like a plate of rice or something. So I think that is a huge problem. Either we stop telling to everybody that it's gluten-free or healthy and just like say nothing, make like very small notes for people who actually care about it, and people who afraid of that won't just like won't even notice, because you know it's just stupid. You can have something that tastes as crap in a normal place as well, because there is like the whole concept, and I would say the whole misconception about eating healthy, that it tastes like grass and it doesn't taste good. You know, usual food tastes bad as well. So for me, as a like a food business owner and also the food business owner who works in wellness, to me it's a big issue, you know. Like I was just like, wow, like a lot of our clientele is men, and for them to actually like us and choose us among other options, we have to use other words. I'm really rethinking the way we pitch our business to our clients now. So I'm trying not to use word healthy, because it's just so repelling. We say clean, good food, which is like, you can't really guess what's inside. Is it dairy free? Is it gluten free? It's just clean. Came over to see a little flea market that happens once a month for 2 days. Let's see what this treasure hunt will bring me. To be honest, most of it is just crap, so you really need to dig in and like look, watch carefully for your bags too. So let's see what did I got on the flea market today. Well, the backup story is that I used to work in fashion as a buyer. First as a buyer to for brand, and then I opened my own shop. First in Kazakhstan, back home, and then I moved it to Paris. So my job was, one of my jobs among others, were looking for the interesting up-and-coming brands from all over. Most of them were from UK and States. So I brought them to Kazakhstan and brought them to France. Most of them were stocked in Paris for the first time. And almost all of them you can now find in Galeries Lafayette, Champs-Élysées. So once I quit fashion, I started to work in wellness, but that's 100% another story. The story now is that I still have this passion of like searching, looking, like trying to find something interesting, something one of a kind, and at the same time, something that you can wear for, like something they can use for every day. That says about clothes and about jewelry as well. So the jewelry, the whole like vintage thing to me is like a game, you know, like you go there, you go on the market, or maybe even you might be, some of you are going to auctions, and you like have to go through all of these items, things that's like some other person doesn't need anymore, and maybe somebody bought it from
from someone else who were out of business. Anyhow, like going through all of these things, you need to find something exciting, something interesting, something that you will like and something your client might like. You know, in my case, like being a buyer was a lot of to do with numbers, of course, but from the other side, it's just me being super curious, you know, super interested to find something one of a kind. So when you go to the, for me, when I go to the flea market, it's like a part of the game, and I have to go through a lot of crap and like a lot of things that they pitch you as antique, and that's all, this is from the that age, and that's from this century. So you need to find the balance, you know, like to find something good quality, interesting, maybe something old, but the time to do with like old and antique stuff is that they are just better quality. That's the only reason. So what I found today is these cute earrings. Who knows the brand? There is no brand. It's just silver. Yes, here. They are like this, and it's pretty easy to wear them every day. That's first. There was a lot of things, you know, like, and honestly, a lot of things are just basically from like, basically new, and you can just buy something for super cheap. But I wanted to find something unusual. So another thing is these earrings that I thought that are old enough for me to buy them. This is also silver with a stone. I don't know the name of the stone anyway, so I think it's cute. Also, I just found out that the blue is very suit me very well. Yeah. And another one, the other ones that I like the most are these ones here. That's also silver. I don't know the name of the stone, but she told me actually, I forgot. Here. So, how pretty is that? That's it. So, going to the flea market whenever you are, just, I don't know, be curious, don't buy things too fast. Watch around, try to find something interesting, something that speaks to your heart as well. And sometimes, you know, you can even manage to find something branded, like for example, I did found one necklace. I think the brand was in Barcelona. It was this weekend. It was from Cacharel, a super old. You could see the quality, and like there was a stone, and just the whole work was amazing. And just because the seller was so annoying, he first said it's 40, and then I was trying to bargain, and then he said no, and when we came back he said 100, so I was just pissed I didn't got it. But the piece was amazing. But the piece was beautiful. That was just my character being very Sima, you know. Anyhow, so that's it. So quickly, just wanted to show you how to order things at the like super usual restaurant in Barcelona with the local food. Among others, I ordered something that's suitable for my like diet, let's say, and something that I can share with if I'm eating not alone. So let's see. So for example, these are my salad. So everything here is basically allowed, and also there's fish, there's tomatoes, everything that I need. Here is the peppers. I'm not gonna eat those, but that's
actually also suitable. These are aubergine with cheese. And this 100% allowed because there is like small fish called anchovies or sardine and a bit of olive oil. These a bit too much, that's not for me. That's it. So I did said about that in a previous video about eating desserts. So we just had dinner, which considered as like a early dinner here because it was at 5:30. This is my dessert. This is vegan, full fat, coconut soft serve with pistachios. So basically it's like a fatty, good kind of dessert. So I have two things. I'm happy and I'm having good ice cream ingredients. The things I really enjoy doing is visiting local supermarkets, especially the ones who are like organic ones, like this one for example. I don't know the name, but it's very nice, impressive. It's like to me it would be like Naturalia in Paris, in France. It's very nice. The selection is amazing. I'm looking at the stand of this, like all of this alternative milks. It's really nice. There's even protein, you know, nothing we obsessed more than like counting protein these days. I know because it's me. This is like a part of the research. What? I'm just always stunned by the coconut products. Okay, the serving of kombucha. Just like 1, 2, 3, 4 brands. 5, 6. Six. Amazing. Okay, of course, there is nachos because, hey, we're in Spain. Patatas fritas. Amazing. One, here is the name, Garitas. So basically it's just a steak tartar, and the way they serve it is just not another level, but it's just another way of serving something pretty much basic. This place called Philisopheat. That was the only one I found that was had like sugar-free options and keto options. That's for example like sort of keto cheese. And I just got myself peace. Thank you. Gracias. Another day in Barcelona. Actually so grateful, honestly. It's been 10 days or something, or 10 days or so that I'm here, and it's just completely shifted my, let's say, well-being in a way, because the change of circumstances, the change of surroundings, and the fact that I spend a lot of time just by myself alone, that's amazing. So it's Saturday morning, and it's quite, well, it's pretty quiet outside, and I kind of love that too. I found another Pilates studio, not so far, and I'm gonna check it out. I am alone here, all by myself. So I guess post-workout glow should be a thing. And done, and the class was great, and actually the girl who was the coach was nice. She, cute girl from Argentina, she said. And the happiest part, that was only three people. And what I noticed about Barcelonians, they are not very much morning people. It's like in Kazakhstan we have classes full from starting from 7 a.m. 7, 8, and like all day long. Here, the first class was at, oh my god, the first class was at 9, so I had to wait because I wake up at 6:30, had to wait while until it starts, and now I'm heading to my breakfast, like the best part of the day. Actually, I want to have my first coffee solo, all alone by myself. And there is one cute place that I visited recently. The coffee was great. The French guy running it, and no connection, just like nice place. Skipping the French guy coffee shop because I passed it. Or it didn't open yet. Well, he's French, you know. He's not waking up too early, especially on Saturday morning. So there is a cute coffee shop in our hotel. The coffee is great too, so going there. Got back from the Pilates to change and off for breakfast. That's the shirt that I got yesterday in the jeans. Okay, can I just say that I love these earrings? And according to the seller, it is antique. Which, honestly, for me, I think it adds value, and I am will happy to pay extra for that. There's so many dogs here. These are Timon and this is Pumba. What is this? How beautiful. I have no idea, just another part of the city. It is so gorgeous. Just like fundamental, beautiful. The reason why we got here is what was this Pavilion de Miss Van der Roy. I read somewhere that people get upset that it's smaller in like in real life than on a picture, and it's actually really smaller. But it, knowing the fact that it was built 100 years ago, drives me nuts. Insane. I think there is a, my theory behind that is that this guy was connected to his inner self really well, that he got the idea. That's the theory that I just made up. He got the idea during his, I don't know, meditation or like being under drugs or something. Or something like that. Maybe he did used some sort of, you know, like practice something. Anyhow, you got the idea and this came up because there is no other explanation how he could think of something like that that long time ago. Okay, explain this. Ready? There is something. Should be. I say it's meditations. Like he practiced meditation a lot. Okay, not me doing check feet in front of the, still feel super embarrassed when people see that I record. Anyhow, that's the golden onyx that actually cost 20% of the whole budget of this pavilion that I just discovered. Anyhow, that's the outfit check. The earrings are from the market, like the antique ones, and the whole outfit is That's really one of the best ice cream I ever had. The name is Salva. Ogo. I will never understand this. How come people wake up so early and run for like 42, 20, 10, 5? Don't you have other things to do? That's pretty amazing. So that's our last morning in Barcelona, and we are at the airport waiting for boarding to Paris to start. And this is my favorite part about Barcelona, leaving to Paris. But to be honest, that was my first time ever. I spent 2 weeks straight somewhere, not in Almaty, not in Paris, and it felt really completely different and unattached, you know, in a way. And also I found Barcelona is amazing city to live at, and also super convenient when you have, I guess, when you have kids, because the city built the way that it's just so organized that you can walk miles, you know. I just counted on the way here, so we did walked 200 kilometers in total for 2 weeks, and it's something about like 16,000 steps a day. And I think it's only because the city is just so comfortable. It's so easy to walk, it's so easy to be a pedestrian, you know, like you don't need a car. I don't think I would need a car if I would live in Barcelona, but honestly, that's like the best part, what I loved about the city. The food in general is just, I try to feel more like local, and I build my life around that, but I don't see any really much difference in pricing between Paris and Barcelona. I was comparing stuff like, I don't know, Pilates studios are quite the same price, and I would say in Paris they are much better. Food, somebody says that it's cheaper. I can't say it's cheaper, it's pretty much the same. Quality, pretty much the same quality as well, except if you want a seafood, it's just here, like the sea, and you know, like the seafood is actually, to me, is like the main product here. So what else? People. Well, first, they are not really morning people. If you wake up early like me at 6:30, you really have to wait, and it's better for you to take a breakfast at your hotel, because otherwise you will be starving until 8 or 9. Really, coffee scene is amazing. A lot of coffee places that I love, and a lot of places to have breakfast at as well. And I don't know, would I live in Barcelona? Maybe just like a few months, a year. But knowing that I have responsibilities back home, like I have kids that I'm responsible for, that would be a bit complicated with school and stuff. But like for younger people, younger couples, that's amazing opportunity, and that's an amazing city to live at. So that's it. Thank you guys for watching, and another vlog is coming up about Paris, of course, because we are booked in Paris only for 2 days, because we have things to do and few appointments. And we are leaving really in 3 days to Almaty. So thank you for watching.